combine driver, hogging up the road on my plower, chugga-lugga-lugging 5 miles an hour on my international harvester. 3 miles of cars laying on their horns, falling on deaf ears of corn, lined up behind me like a big parade of late to work road rage jerks, shouting obscene words, flipping me the bird. Well, you may be on a state paid road.
Whatever happened to predictability? The milkman, the paperboy, evening TV. You miss your old familiar friends, but waiting just around the bend. Everywhere you look, everywhere there's you go.
All right, now we're downtown here at our Wanamingo location where my beautiful mother, Sue, is in charge. Mom, how's it going?
It's going great this morning. It's sunny, it's beautiful.
Yeah, we got one more day till we're opening up. It's April 30th today, and tomorrow is our opening day, May 1st, and with this whole COVID-19 and coronavirus, we're gonna have to do some things differently this year, but Mom, why don't you show us around quick?
All right, come on in.
Yep.
We've had to do some precautions for COVID-19, so you'll notice some changes. as we're walking through here, you'll notice Jim is writing up an invoice.
What's up, Dad?
Say hi, Ashley.
What's up, Ashley?
Everybody's getting ready for the opening tomorrow.
You also do weddings and proms usually and stuff in your floral area here. Yeah.
Floral, but now that is canceled.
Okay.
Now, so come on into this greenhouse.
No.
We're spacing stuff. We've got lots of stuff going. Our helper Becky.
What's up, Becky?
She's spacing
some things back there.
First day back this year. Yeah. Yeah.
So.
Nice.
Yeah.
Looks good.
Growing in here and.
Looks good. All right. Lead us to the next one.
Alrighty.
What do you do here, Mom? This is a little new, a little different.
This is kind of just an antique corner and a little bit of nostalgia.
Got the little...
This one is my family and Jim's family, Jack's mom and dad. So we both grew up kind of at the Minneapolis and St. Paul farmers markets. This is my grandpa in his greenhouses, my grandma, my uncle, Jim's dad.
Yeah, even that's you, isn't it?
Where?
Right here?
Nope, that's my mom.
Oh, all right.
Actually, so.
Have you got?
Yeah, and my aunt. So yeah, so those are kind of fun pictures. This was an article way back when. I can't even remember what year it was, but you can tell by it. There's Jack and our daughter Ellen, how long ago it was. Greenhouse tomatoes, lots of fun stuff.
Dad, look at us in this picture, huh? Me and you and the tomato?
Yes, sir.
This one is, we were followed by a photographer and a writer for 2 days, kind of our made for the market. He followed us kind of on our picking and our processing and our selling
of
the product.
Tim's even doing vegetables still.
Tim, yep.
All right.
He is young there, but now he is late 30s.
All right.
Yeah.
Next greenhouse.
All right. Now we're going into the succulent house. So this is not full yet, but this is just a few choice succulents for people for their succulent gardens, fairy gardens, that kind of thing.
Okay.
Okay. This is pretty much our petunia house.
Very nice.
Million bells. We've got our geranium baskets here. Uh-huh. Our container gardens here. Yeah, like I said.
Looks really good, Mom. You're working really hard.
Well, you know.
We all do.
Every year is the same. We all work together as a family, and it just seems to work out. So.
Yep. All right.
Yep.
What's your favorite part about working as a family, Mom? It gets stressful. Sometimes me and you get into it. Me and Dad, you and Dad, Grandpa and us, you know.
Yep. Family is wonderful, but being with family on, 12, 14 hours a day, sometimes gets to be a lot of personality and a lot of, different ideas.
Yep.
So, yep. We just roll with it on a daily basis. So, this is just kind of a hodgepodge greenhouse. So we've got a lot of trailing things, and we've got a lot of accent plants, coleus,
yep.
Million bells, verbena. So yeah, we've just got a lot of...
So what are some of the guidelines we're going to have to do this year with the coronavirus and COVID-19?
Oh, well, definitely hand washing is a big issue.
Yep.
And definitely we've got to... abide by the CDC and the governor's orders on what to do. We have to stay, 6 feet apart. Yep. And
this is kind of our workstation. Dad built us.
Yep.
Filling urns and stuff.
Yep. And then we're going to the vegetable house out here. We continually keep moving stuff. Today's going to be a big moving day for us because obviously we're opening tomorrow.
Yep.
From the growing range to down here. So
this one isn't quite full yet, but
nope,
later today
it will be. Yep. So we don't have much in choice down here yet, but by today this will be full.
Perfect.
So.
All right, yeah. Mom. Well, thanks a lot for showing me around.
Not a problem.
Earlier today, my mom and I did the interview about our Beulke's greenhouse downtown in Wanamingo. Now we're going to take some time and show our farm operation. Dad, we're kind of talk about the farm and what we got here and how many greenhouses and whatnot. Yep.
What you saw this morning.
How many onions do we plant?
There's like 5,000 red and 10,000 yellow.
Yep. You know, some machinery that we got there in the background. Even got Grandpa. It looks like he's planting some corn.
Yep, he's out there.
Grandpa's 92 years old and still going out there. All right, so these are kind of our newer greenhouses.
These tomatoes are outside because it's such a beautiful day. They get stronger if they sit outside.
Yep. Typical sign here, my dad getting a phone call. Gets about 20 a day. More than that, probably.
Okay, then here is the urns for the cemetery and some miscellaneous plants in here. Once it gets a little bit picked over in town, then we keep working on here and bring them to the town or the auctions or the market.
Yep. So we bring our, what are all the locations we bring our stuff to?
Pretty much the St. Charles auction. We take a little bit to the Riceville, Iowa auction. And then the Minneapolis and St. Paul markets, and then in town.
And then Cameron. And
Cameron, Ace Hardware in Kenyon.
Okay. Got some cherry tomatoes coming already.
Yep. These are all geraniums for like late May for Memorial Day.
Yeah. When did you plant these cherry tomatoes?
They were seeded probably late January and then transplanted in these pots probably late February.
Mm-hmm.
But it took about 2 months now to get them to that stage.
Gotcha.
Kind of messy here, Jack, but this is kind of work in progress. We have some tomatoes in there. We're going to clean up this straw and stuff.
Yep.
And get them in shape. And this one's got the crank side, so if it's a really nice day like this, we can open them right up like this. But we had straw in there a few years ago, but that didn't work out real good, so we're going to take that out.
So what's your favorite part about being a greenhouse grower and a vegetable farmer?
Trying to hopefully get good stuff, whether it's flowers or vegetables.
Yep.
It's hard to do that, but you try. Here's green beans and some tomatoes in the hoop house, and then we are going to fill this side up with these pots and then more tomatoes, because this type of tomato we have to tie up to these purlins.
Uh-huh.
And we string them up.
Gotcha.
Another one we're working on. We'll put all plant tomatoes in here.
Yep. So how long have you been going to the farmers markets and selling and having your own greenhouses? So you built all these basically by yourself, or you had some help, but you built all these greenhouses by hand.
Kind of when I was like a senior in high school, and then right out of high school, okay. We did a lot of this building, like in 85, 90s and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And here's where we shred a lot of the dirt with this dirt shredder. It's kind of a work area, grow stuff. Urns are in here too, greenhouse tomatoes. And then all smaller flowers. So when we get sold out in town, that we got some nicer ones towards the end of May.
Yep. How many urns do we do?
Right around 850.
Okay, so we do 850 of these potted up urns. And we basically do that all about Goodhue County, right?
Pretty much.
How many cemeteries do we go to?
I think there's 24.
Okay. All right. Looks, and here we got a lot of our tomatoes. How many greenhouse tomatoes do you think we have?
About 500 plants.
Okay.
In the greenhouse, and then maybe 2,000 or 3,000 in the field we plant.
Yep. Pretty soon we're gonna have to start caging them, it looks like.
Yep.
Sure.
And staking them. Starting to get big.
Mm-hmm. And I see this here. This is basically our sponsor here. How many bags of potting mix do you think we buy a year?
Well, probably about 800.
For tomatoes, for
other... everything. Yep, wherever I can get deals on them.
Yep, mostly from Menards though.
Menards, a lot of it, or any place. Yep. Here's some real little tomatoes yet going to be for late May and stuff.
Gotcha. And here we even got some lettuce and peppers.
Yeah, this is just kind of an experiment to fill up the bench space. These are cherry tomatoes. So you saw those cherry tomatoes up in the other greenhouse. So when them are done, these are cherry tomatoes. So hopefully we'll have fresh ones here.
Yep.
And this is just some peppers and lettuce to fill up the gaps.
Gotcha. We got some more tomatoes. Yep. And then these ones, are we going to string up or are we going to cage them?
These on the in this big dirt area, we're going to string up. Mm-hmm. The other ones, we're going to cage.
All right. Gotcha. So how many greenhouses do we have in total? We got 10 at home and 5 downtown, correct?
Yep.
Gotcha. So what are some of your hobbies you like to do when you're not farming?
I kind of a couple of things in the winter. I do like to snowmobile a little bit.
Yep.
And then do farm toy setups.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. I know that. I mean, I know you take pride in that. I know a lot of people. You even made the front page of the paper in Zimbrota this year.
We did. Yep. Thanks to your help.
Yep. Do you appreciate Mom, Dad, Ellen's help?
I do.
All right.
Yes, I do. And
sometimes,
Dad,
sometimes I don't know.
Grandpas and brothers and sisters help out. Yep. Nephews, whoever.
Yep, for sure.
Friends. In this one, there's urns and patio tomatoes and just more flowers.
Okay.
To replenish.
So what's your favorite flower you grow?
I don't know. They're all good when they're nice, but probably geraniums are good because they're easy to grow and they're not so finicky. They're tough.
Yep. How about vegetable? What's your favorite thing to eat? Favorite vegetable to grow?
To eat or to grow?
Both.
Oh, here's some more tomatoes and peppers that we're going to put in that hoop house. To eat, I really like green beans and like sweet corn.
Yep.
It's kind of, if you can get nice tomatoes, it's fun to grow tomatoes and sell them. They're kind of nice to pick and sell.
Yep.
I don't know.
So what's your least favorite job to do on the farm? Something you don't ever get excited
about. Favorite job?
Yep.
Probably just a lot of cleaning and fixing.
Yep.
It's a lot to do and it's got to be done and
yep.
Takes time.
And here we got the market truck. Where did you and, I think you and Grandpa got it, right?
Right, we went to Lincoln, Nebraska to get that 2 or 3 years ago. And it's an older truck, it's 20 years old, but it only had like 80,000 miles on it.
Okay.
It works out good for plants and vegetables.
Gotcha. And it's refrigerated, correct?
Yep.
So you can put
a door for the market.
Yeah, for sure. Well, thanks, Dad, for showing me around the home farm.
You're welcome.
How's it going, Grandpa?
Well, not too bad this morning, Jack.
Yeah? You gonna go plant some corn after this?
Yeah, I think so.
Good.
Trying enough.
Bert and Tim got you some more seed to use?
Yeah, so we got seed, yeah.
Perfect. All right, Grandpa, so you were the first one to kind of move down here. Kind of explain why you moved to Wanamingo.
Well, when we were looking for a farm, there was one for sale down here, and I don't know, we kind of liked it. I guess that's we were forced out of our other farm up there in Egan.
Yep.
The highway took the farm.
Yep.
And so that's why. It's a nice community down here in Wanamingo.
Yep, for sure. What's kind of your favorite part about farming?
What part of it?
Yep.
Oh, I don't know. I like all of it, but this gardening is kind of interesting.
Yeah?
Yeah, a lot of work, though.
Yeah, what's your least favorite part about farming?
Well, all the hard work.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, but still, it's fun. When everything goes pretty good, it's fun.
Yeah, so you're happy you chose Wanamingo to move down to and everything?
Oh, yeah, it's nice down here in Wanamingo. People were all nice to us.
Yep.
It was nice.
Perfect. Couple of quick questions. What's your favorite vegetable to eat, Grandpa?
Oh, tomatoes.
Tomatoes?
Yeah.
All right. And you plant and you grow all these flowers for my mom and dad also. What's your favorite flower?
Geraniums.
Geraniums? Why is that?
Oh, they're just a nice flower. They can take a lot of drought in the summer. And
yeah.
They're just a pretty flower.
Yeah.
They're all good. I do like geraniums.
Yep. I'm surprised you like that. Usually you have to water all these urns and that's all they have.
Yeah.
Takes up a lot of your time.
Yeah.
Sure. All right, Grandpa. Thanks. Still having fun, Grandpa, at 92, farming? Getting harder?
Yeah.
A lot of.
Talk about an uphill battle, 2000.
thousand acres of beans and cattle. But he don't ever get rattled. He just goes till the sun goes down. Hydraulic fluid on his jeans, red dye diesel and 10 rows between. A cold one on the porch and a good night's sleep. Y'all hold him up with me now. Here's to the farmer that plants the fields in the spring, that turned from green to that harvest honey. Hold one up for the banker downtown that got him on his feet with handshake money. Here's to the farmer's wife that loves him every night, raising a son, raising a daughter. They gather around the table, send it up to the father. Somehow they get closer when times get harder. Here's to the farmer. Subdivisions creeping on in, neighborhood kids keep jumping his fence. He could double his money, but that'd be the end of a promise he'll never break. 'Cause he looked his daddy in the eye, and he's got that stubborn pride. He'll be here till the day he dies. No, he wouldn't have it any other way. Here's to the farmer that plants the fields in the spring, that turned from green to that harvest honey. Hold one up for the banker downtown that got him on his feet with handshake money. Here's to the farmer's wife that loves him every night, raising a son, raising a daughter. They gather around the table, send it up to the father. Somehow they get closer when times get harder. Here's to the farmer. I'm a God-fearing, hard-working combine driver, hogging up the road on my plower, chugga-lugga-lugging 5 miles an hour on my international harvester.
hard-working combine driver, hogging up the road on my flower, chugga-lugga-lugging 5 miles an hour on my International Harvester.
Yeah.